Napoleon Grill headquarters.
We are back with Mandy Landefeld. She is a lifestyle expert all the way from Atlanta.
All the way in from Georgia, baby.
You
we are bringing some southern charm to Utah.
Oh, I'm so excited. We just got a shot of that yummy looking whatever it is.
Butternut squash bruschetta with goat cheese and a figgy onion glaze and pistachios and thyme.
It looks incredible. So you actually run a blog and a brand called Sumptuous Living. I love it.
Meaty and juicy.
And that's exactly what all of this is. So let's jump right in. How are we getting started?
Well, we are first going to start with roasting some butternut squash, which a lot of times, sometimes you want to go ahead and pick it up in the market that's already cubed. If you want to do that, that's fine. But a great trick to getting your butternut, have you ever tried to cut it and it's like a pain in the patootie?
No.
It's so hard. You have to be like Arnold Schwarzenegger to be able to get through that stuff. So if you microwave them whole, just like our big whole, don't cut them, don't do anything.
You're sticking that whole thing in the microwave?
Whole puppy goes into the microwave.
For how long?
For like 5 minutes.
Okay.
And it will not cook it. It'll just make it a breeze to cut through, to peel, to cut through it, and then to core out the center. And then you just cube it up.
That is a fantastic tip. I've never
so
heard of that.
So fast, because otherwise you're like, argh!
Right.
I mean, it's insane.
So how much of that are you cubing up for this recipe?
So I go ahead and I make the whole butternut squash.
Because
if you're going to go ahead and cube it up, you're going to toss it with some olive oil, salt, and pepper, Creole seasoning, which is totally my jam. I'll eat a shoe with Creole seasoning.
Creole seasoning?
Like Cajun, Creole, like Tony Satin. There's all these fabulous ones out. Whatever your favorite one is, you know, you just go ahead and toss it up in your sheet pan and roast it off. And you're going to wind up with this beautiful roasted butternut squash.
This time of year especially, I feel like squash is everything I want.
And if you have any extra, all you have to do is put it in to your pot with some chicken stock and a little cream. Make the most fabulous butternut squash bisque. So leftovers are never a bad thing.
Easy.
We even eat them in omelets. Like,
love
we love butternut squash, and it's great and healthy. So we're going to take some toasted, crostini is basically toasted bread. So ciabatta bread that you go ahead and toast up. We're going to go ahead and top our, and I'm using goat cheese. I want to come back as a goat cheese fromagier, like, in my next life. I love goat cheese. I would eat it on anything.
So love that you're sophisticated with your goat cheese, and I love that you're not being shy about the bruschetta.
No, you gotta smear that stuff on. Maybe it's gotta go slather.
Because we're sumptuous.
Yes, exactly. Well, also, you know, I'm not so much of a bread person. I want to taste the food more than I want to taste the bread.
See, and I feel like that's always my mistake, is I love my bread and my carbs.
So
I need to be careful about that.
I am all about it. So in there, we've gone ahead and topped our stuff, but the next part is this luscious, the most amazing figgy onion sauce. So we have sauteed up some onions, which is a great tip for the holidays. For Thanksgiving, when you're prepping ahead, if you saute up your onions in advance, you can make a big, huge batch.
Okay, so are you just layering it on there?
Yeah, actually, what we're going to do is in here, in this Cuisinart, we've got our onions, we've got some fig jam straight out of the jar, and balsamic vinegar. Three ingredients,
easy,
and done. And you go ahead and put it in there, give it a little bit of a root, that one. So we're going to zip it up because it's making too much noise.
Magic of TV, it's done.
Right, exactly.
And how much of that are you getting on there?
It's all of it. None of it is like a recipe.
It's almost like a jelly consistency.
Yeah, a recipe is a guide. And this stuff on biscuits, that's the southern part of us. We love our biscuits out down in Atlanta. But it's so good on brie, on any kind of a cheese platter. Phenomenal. So we're going ahead and drizzling that on. Doesn't that look amazing?
I'm starting to smell all of it right now.
Good.
My mouth is watering.
All right, so what I would like you to do is go ahead and sprinkle on some pistachios.
Okay, that I can do.
Roasted pistachios straight out of the bag. All we did was chop them up.
This looks
easy peasy.
So
and every part of this can be prepped in advance. You should not have anything on your Thanksgiving menu that can't be made in advance.
And what's this stuff I'm putting on right
thyme.
Now?
Thyme. Fresh thyme, which is the perfect task for kiddos, but it gives that finishing touch, and you always make sure you have a fabulous drink. We've got some gorgeous mocktails here, like grapefruit, wonderful things, but this is the best appetizer to like wrap up your traditional menu. Isn't it good?
Oh my gosh. This is so
I know! So
and I just took a not TV bite because I don't even care, you guys.
So you can get the recipe at sumptuousliving.net. That's our blog. And we will make sure that your Thanksgiving is fabulous.
Thank you so much. We
appreciate
you.
You
can post all this information on our website as well. All the info right there on your screen. And we will be right back.
Bye. Thank you. Happy Thanksgiving.
Cabinets and mantel for Good Things Utah, provided by Maple Landing Custom Cabinets and Wood.